lose the one you love, to finally have to say goodbye. You try to be strong, but the pain keeps holding on, and all that you can do is cry. Deep within your heart, you know it's time to move on. When the fairy tale that you once knew is gone, when the last teardrop falls, I'll still be holding on to all of our memories and all of what it used to be.
Day that passes by, I don't think of you. shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Please take your programs, turn with me to the opening hymn, How Great Thou Art.
That the words that come forth today, it will help all of us to
draw closer to you before it is too late. Be with your daughter. No, Lord, who have faith just a moment ago. Lord, touch her that she may recognize your touch, Lord, and help her that she will recover in a mighty way. Be with us, Lord. Thank you for hearing and thank you for answering our prayers. In your most precious and holy name we pray. Amen.
This is from Psalms 90. It will be done by Joan Ramsey and Kimberly Ramsey, daughter and granddaughter, followed by a selection from Angela, family friend.
The first one is taken from, Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth and over, and forever thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. Thou turnest man to destruction and sayest, return, ye children of men. For a thousand years in thy sight are but as yesterday when it is past, and as a watch in the night. Thou carest them away as with a blood. They are asleep in the morning and are like grass which break up. In the morning it flourisheth and groweth up, and in the evening it is cut down and withered. For we are consumed by thy anger, and by thy wrath are we troubled. Thou hast set our iniquities before thee, our secret sins in the light of thy countenance. For all our days are passed away in thy wrath. We spend our years as a tale that is told. Tenth and last. The days of our years are 70 years, and if by reason of strength they are 80 years, yet their strength labor and sorrow, for it is soon cut off, and we fly away.
White, followed by remembrance from Faithy, followed by the second lesson from Romans 8. 31 to 39 by Jamil Ramsey, grandson.
Bereaved family members, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. It's never an easy task to lose a loved one, but I'm here to encourage you today that God is with you. And we trust that He has your back. And we encourage us. And Isaiah 41, verse 11 states, fear not, for I am with thee. Do not be dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with my right hand of my righteousness. Be encouraged. And as I sing this song today, I want you to, yes, we're mourning for Norma, but we ought to remember that at the end of the day, our lives should be reflecting one that God wants, so that when He comes, we will be with Him. Praise God.
I hear the sound of the mighty rushing wind, and it's closer now. Trials and trials of the Lord.
lesson in Romans 8:31-39. What shall we then say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up from us all, how shall he not with him? How shall he not with him also all? He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up from us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifieth. Who is he that condemneth? It is Christ that died, he rather that is risen again, who is even at the right hand of God, who also maketh intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulations or distress or persecutions or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in these things we are more than conquerors. Through him that loveth us. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things presented, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creatures shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord.
This time, with the remembrance by Faithlin and Owen.
Remembering our dear grandmother, let us all fondly recall how dearly each of us love you. If only we believe that we are really saying goodbye, our mind knows that you are gone, but our heart will not accept it. Although no words cannot express the depth of God we feel, time cannot steal the treasure that we carry in our heart. Your precious memory will always cast a gentle glow. It was Cicero who said, the life given by nature is short, but the memory of a life well spent is eternal. Your life was well spent with your family and friends. Your life was a blessing, your memory a treasure. You are loved beyond measure. You are a soldier, and even when times were tough, you taught us many things in life. The only thing you didn't do was to help us get through life without you. Though you passed on before us, you are always in our heart, and though we are not together, we'll never be apart.
Amen. We reach a point in this Thanksgiving service where the family of the late Norma Foster have given us the privilege to collect an offering in aid of the community service department. So at this time we ask the deacons to come forward for us. We thank you for good health and we thank you for strength. Lord, as we are about to receive a special gift on your behalf, so we can go forth and do your work and work, so others can come to know you before it is too late. We ask you to bless it in a mighty way. Bless everyone who will be passed
participating by giving us a special gift at this time. Thank you for hearing and thank you for answering our prayers. In the most precious and holy name we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
Praise the Lord!
Praise God. And I'm singing this song today for the family and friends. Praise God. I've been in the storm, and it seems like said, you make me cry. But praise God today, I own all my friends on the side of the rivers of joy.
Since last week,
the lady that cleans the place says to me, she remembers when she used to buy chicken back for $80. Now chicken back is selling for $160. And the price of chicken has gone up. And she's saying she don't know how she's gonna make it. There are other persons who are facing other dilemmas of back to school. They don't know how school will work out in September. Persons are saying they don't even have money to start purchasing clothing for back to school. And with all of that, there are some persons that are facing the loss of a loved one. Now you might ask yourself the question, with all of this, how can I stand here and say that this is not the worst year or the worst things that have could happen? But the Bible says that before sin is over, we must go through trials and tribulation. The only way, though, that we can go through these times and smile at the storm is if we have connection with Jesus Christ. There's no other way you can go through these times. If you go through trying not to have Jesus in your corner, then your face is about to be long. No smiles on your face. But with Jesus, you can smile at the storm. I want to leave you with some promises that God gave. One of the greatest promises that I think that God has given to his people that sometimes we seem to overlook and forget. In Isaiah chapter 40 and verse 28, it says, I'm reading from the New King James Version, it says, have you not known? Have you not heard? The everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, neither faints, and the young men shall not fall. But those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. God is saying, he will give you strength to endure this time. He will give you the power to stand up and face all the circumstances that will be coming at you. Answer the chapter of our mother. Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you. I will trouble you with my righteous right hand. Because God holds your hand. You will not fall. You will not fail. Because God is in control. Gentle talk. We are used to the roughness. So because of the roughness don't come. We said, for I have redeemed you. losing your loved one, God is saying that I am there for you. I will give you peace. I will comfort your souls. And though you may question, why God did you do this? Why did you allow this to happen? Let us understand that once there is sin in the world, there must be death. I struggled to come to this funeral today, although I gave my consent from a very long time. You know why? A very good friend of mine, a business partner of mine, died on Wednesday night. And I've done many funerals. But for some reason or the other, this one hit home hard. And sometimes, brethren, you need to follow the voice of the Lord. When I was leaving work at around 8:30 Wednesday night, a voice came to me and said, go and look for Paul. Because the workplace is close by. The furniture place. And I said to myself, if I go to look for Paul now, he's going to talk. We're going to talk for a long time. And I didn't want to go and we're there talking for a long time and then my wife calls. And here I'm at Paul talking, and when I should be home, and get upset. So I decided not to go by Paul. Instead, I went home. A Thursday morning, I got a call from another friend saying that Paul died around 9 o'clock. How he died? He was working on one of the machines in his establishment, woodwork. And he was fixing a motor when he got electrocuted. He was the only one there. And I understand that the other friend went there just walking through and heard a faint voice calling for somebody to help. But when they went, the current had done all the damage that he could not make. And that's the reason why I take it so hard. Because if I had gone, the possibility exists that he would be alive today. If by the time we walk out this church, who next will pass? Live good within one another. That's one of the reasons why God came on this earth, to show us how to live with one another. Because he recognized that many of us will not do things to go against what God says. Many of us will go to church. Many of us will walk with the Bible. Many of us are very holy. But let me tell you something. No matter how holy you think you are, if you can't live with your brother and sister here, you can't go to heaven. You can't live up there. You need to practice it here now. So let us don't get it twisted. Not because you're in good jacket, in good suit, and go to church, and I can sing very well. is one of the whole nature of man. Also, let us learn to listen to the voice of God. When God speaks to you, brethren, listen and obey. It may be for your own good, and it also may be to save somebody else's life. Today, if you have not yet made a connection with God, try and make a connection with Him. Don't think that you have committed so many sins and so many wrongs that you can't talk to God. God did not come for the righteous, but He came to bring sinners to repentance. God loves sinners, but He hates sin. The devil wants to fool you and tell you that you commit too much sin. You can't go to church. You can't know God. The criminal was on the cross. He was about to die. He was a criminal. But he said to Jesus, "Remember me when thou comest." What did God say? Today, you will be with me in heaven. Today, know God for yourself. Let nobody trick you. Let nobody tell you. Test Him. Try Him and prove Him. Because God is here for you. Obey His words and listen to Him as we go from strength to strength.
Amen, church. A message has come to us. Let us reflect on this message and make that decision while the blood runs warm in our veins before it is too late. St. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish but have everlasting life." Amen. At this time, we'll go to the eulogy for the late Norma Veronica Foster, and it will be done by Rosemary Robinson.
Good afternoon, everyone. We are here today to remember the life of Norma Foster and to celebrate what she meant to us all. For those of you who I haven't yet have the pleasure of meeting, I am Rosemary, the second child of Miss Norma. I am sure you all will agree with me by sharing Dave Hodges' quote when he say, "Life has a funny way of teaching us." It will create a deep sadness, so we know how to truly understand happiness. It will create chaos in our lives, so that we may appreciate the peaceful times. It will also take those we love away from us, so that we will truly understand what their presence meant to us. End of quote. Today, as I reflect on this meaningful quote, life has given family and friends 100 reasons to cry. But we show life that we have 1,000 reasons to smile when we remember the memories of a dear friend, a mother, a special grandma, a sister, a niece, a wonderful, resourceful, beautiful woman. Eulogy for the late Norma Veronica Foster. Norma, as she was affectionately called, she was the fourth of 8 siblings, Marvelyn, Clyde, Barbara, John, Michael, Babsy, and Edwin. I reflect on how God chose the specific design of this unique individual as she was born at 8 Job Lane, Kingston on July 1, 1957 to proud parents Cindy Foster and Mireille Jadibun, who predeceased her in 2010. For those who the Lord graciously provided in her life to help shape her path into motherhood and adulthood can never be underestimated because it helped her to gain her independence. Norma left Kingston when she was 9 months old to reside in Ashton, Westmoreland. She was raised by her grandparents as her mother migrated to England to seek gainful employment. Like any other little girls going to Sunday school, was a part of her significant life journey. She received her formal education at Ashton Elementary School. Once again, the provision of her growing up in the country had provided her the opportunity to sew with her hands and to cook tasty meals, among other skills, which would mold her in the world of work. A genuine self-made individual. Norma worked her way at various entities such as Ramsey's Hardware, Free Zone, Mickey's Seasoning Shop to meet the needs of her own family, as she started a family of her own. Norma loved cooking, and her meals were very tasty and delicious. She loved music, watching television, and her favorite movie was Walker, Texas Ranger. She loved Young and the Restless. Taking care of her family and a good laugh over coffee with friends and family was always a delight for her. She sacrificed her needs for the good of her family, but she loved doing so. She was loved by so many. She always had the characteristics to brighten someone's day and to make them feel loved. She loved her children and her grandchildren. She loved children, and even if meeting them for the first time, they would be drawn to her. She treated everyone with kindness, love, and respect. Sometimes in bleak places, God sends a sunflower that helps us to move forward with lighter steps. Life scenery is a guarantee to change, and so Norma would make multiple trips overseas to England and Canada, respectively. She described these traveling experiences as a wonderful opportunity, not just to widen her horizon, but to spend quality time with family and friends. Life may be unpredictable and sometimes filled with painful separations, but we can take heart that everything takes place under God's gaze. Neither hard times nor sickness would rob her of what she Neither hard times nor sickness would rob her of who she was, always grateful until God called her home on May 27, 2020. She will be buried today with a blank check numbered 8563, as she always wanted money to spend in paradise. These numbers represent her 8 grandchildren, her 5 children, and one who predeceased her, and her 63 years spent living her own adventure.
to your children, you were a legend and a champion. Mama, we salute you, our queen. She lives to mourn four children, Joan, Rose, Carrie-Anne, and Andre, 8 grandchildren, 2 brothers, 2 sisters, dear friend Eric Welch, daughter-in-law Tanya Thomas, 2 sons-in-law Richard Ramsey and Paolo, a host of other relatives and friends. May her soul rest in peace and life perpetually shine on her. We love you, Nams.
Dedicated to now.
Mama, we miss you, yes we do. Mama, we miss you, yes we do. We miss you. Mama, we all miss you.
And say, and he had more hope.
These are the measured verses we hope to announce for Christ. The readers.
Only 25 persons can enter Medeiros Memorial Garden. Only 25. What a friend we have in Jesus.
Look out. inside.
No man get to come
here. Yeah, go inside again, man. So now go over
there. Take that.
Can't be girl, man. Best syrup and condolence. No.
Sorry, yeah. Life. Just go and take it easy, I'm a friend.
Yeah. Can't sleep, I love you for it. No.
I remember.
when I was about 12 years old. I was going to church, playing church. How many of you used to play church? Let me see your hand. Yeah, some of you still play. And I remember, I go down Mount Calvary, that's where I belong. And I'd jump and I'd shout and I'd come back home. But I was still disobedient. I would talk back. And one day, me and Ann here, we decided that we want to play church. Let me tell you what we did. We went out in the back and started playing church. And my brother was a pastor. Me and Ann here, we were the members in the church. And let me tell you something. It's hard to come in contact with Jesus and still be the same. I don't care who you are. I don't care. You can be the chiefest of sinners. You will never be the same. And I've forgotten. I've been going down to the church, playing church. Came home still disobedient. Didn't want to wash the dishes. Didn't want to bring the clothes in off the line. Didn't want to do anything. Mama said, I'm sick of you going down to that church playing with God. Men and there, we went outdoors, we started playing church. Sat down on the bottom step. There is no other love like mine.
of her. And a loving Father, we thank you for journeying mercies. We thank you for guiding us to this area. We ask, dear Father, that you'll be with the rest of the service.
Drive coming a bit
after.
Yeah. Go again, please. What you do? That's what I want. You see, all I want. Just take a bucket, cast.
Cast the car, all in our water. Different world.
Let us continue with the program. We're going to be singing the second verse of the hymn. When the shadows of this list have gone, I'll fly away. When the shadows of this lift have grown, I'll fly away like a bird from prison bars has flown. Pause for a moment, bow your heads in prayer. Oh kind and loving Father, we thank you once again. You are the one who is in control of this program. We ask, dear Father, to let everything go through in decency and in order, and be with the family members. Continue to guide and protect them and give them peace, for Christ's sake. Amen. Workmen, resurrection on the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. Fear not, I am the first and the last. I am he that liveth and was dead. And behold, I am alive forevermore. From heaven saying unto me, write, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord from henceforth. Yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors and their works to follow them. I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that he sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord
shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout of a loud voice, the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. For as much as it has pleased Almighty God in his love and wisdom to permit our dear sister to fall asleep, we do tenderly commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, in sure and certain hope of a joyful resurrection to eternal life through Jesus Christ, who at his glorious appearing shall change the body of our humiliation. Working whereby he is able even to subdue all things unto himself. While the workmen carry on, we will turn our programs and continue with the singing of the hymn, I'll Fly Away. The third verse says, just a few more weary day and then I'll fly away.
Just a weary day and then I'll fly away to a land where joy shall never end.
Turning to the choruses, chorus that says, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be one more time in the chorus, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. One more time, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
your roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up.
Let us pray.
What kind of living God we thank you for, journey Christ.
I look to you.